voice. You were such a cute little boy, and your father loved you very much. He had big plans for your life, made a special coat just for you.
Well, that's Philip, our housekeeper.
Color's on your back. You were handsome, yes, true. Wonka looking people. When you got to Egypt, our next guest bought you from the Ishmaelite traders.
Well, that's Potiphar, Pharaoh's captain of the guard.
That's right.
Joseph, you became a trusted servant in my house. I could tell that God was with you because he made everything he did successful. I know, dummy, that put you in charge of my house with their meals. Because of you, God blessed all that I own. It was fine until my wife tried to get you to sin, but you were the man to take me and marry God's boss.
Joseph, you did the right thing.
Well, it was God that gave me the strength to stand through the temptation. But God always gives us a way out whenever we're faced with sin. It's up to us to choose his way.
And that's what you did. You didn't think twice. You knew just what to do.
Thank you. you're up to. Stand, foreigners. Where do you come from?
We're from the land of Canaan, sir. There's a terrible famine there. We've come here to buy food.
I think you're spies, and you've come to see the weakness of Egypt.
No, no, sir. We've only come to food.
We're honest men, not spies.
We're the 12 brothers, sons of Jacob, great-grandsons of Abraham. Our youngest brother is at home with his father, and one brother's dead.
forget the day that your brothers returned to Egypt. As soon as you saw them, you turned to me and said, Stu, we're throwing a party. Prepare a feast. Mr. Joseph, when your brothers arrived for lunch and you saw your younger brother, I think he must be a musician. I believe his name is Benjamin.
It's pronounced Benjamin, Stu.
Oh, sorry, Mr. Joseph. Anyway, when you saw him, you got teary-eyed and had to leave the room. I could tell he was your favorite. When it was time for your brothers to return home, you had to set up a little surprise for them. Do you remember what that was, Mr. Joseph?
I certainly do, Stu. Bring them back. We put the money in the sacks, they paid for the grain. And in Benjamin's sack, we put my silver cup.
When they had gone, just a short way from town, you had me go and get them. I had those boys open their bags and I accused them of being thieves. Don't you know they were shocked?
Yeah!
Don't you know they were confused?
Yeah!
Don't you know they were scared?
Yeah!
And don't you know, I load them up on their donkeys and turn them right back to Mr. Joseph.
Yeah!
And here's what happened next.
Thank you. that you were alive. Our family moved to Egypt to be near you so God could provide for us for the last 5 years of the famine.
Of course! That's my father, Jacob!
Thank you.
smoking where I am.